Hi,
my name's Rob Sherwood, and I'm here today to tell you about my tool, FlowVisor. FlowVisor allows researchers to test out new experiments on their production network, at scale, and with real user traffic. In fact, all of the other OpenFlow demonstrations on this website run on top of FlowVisor on our very own production network at Stanford.
OpenFlow is a protocol for managing how packets are controlled in switches and routers. It works by standardizing the interface between control and data planes, and then by moving the control plane off box into a centralized service called the OpenFlow controller. In this video, we show how our tool, FlowVisor, can logically slice an OpenFlow network and allow multiple controllers to concurrently manage different subsets or slices of network resources. Critically, FlowVisor ensures strong isolation between network slices so that actions in one slice do not affect another. FlowVisor works as a transparent layer between switches and multiple controllers. That is, it speaks the OpenFlow protocol both down to the switches and also up to the controllers. In this way, much like a hypervisor X in standard machine virtualization, FlowVisor intercepts all control messages to and from the data path and then sanity checks and rewrites them to ensure isolation. Let's see how this works in practice. In OpenFlow, when a packet arrives at a switch that does not match any cached flow entries, the switch generates a message to the controller asking what to do with packets of this form. The FlowVisor then intercepts this message and makes a policy check to determine which controller is responsible for this packet. The message is then forwarded to the appropriate controller, which makes some forwarding decision, i.e., send all packets that look like this down to port number 5, and then send a corresponding new forwarding rule back down to the switch. The FlowVisor again intercepts the rule and does another policy check, this time to ensure that the new rule does not infringe on the traffic from other slices. Once the rule is approved, it is forwarded onto the switch, cached, and then the packet is forwarded on appropriately. New packets will match the cached rule and are then forwarded without going through this process again. Thus, slicing with the FlowVisor imposes no performance penalty on packet forwarding, and packets are forwarded at full line rate. So, if we use FlowVisor to slice every switch and router in our network, we can create logical copies of the same physical network. This allows potentially faulty experiments to run alongside existing production network services. In other words, FlowVisor will allow researchers and network operators to try out new ideas on their real networks without interfering with its normal day-to-day operations. What you're seeing here is a graphical monitoring program of the sliced Stanford OpenFlow network. The physical network, shown in the top middle, is sliced into 4 experimental slices, shown in each of the 4 corners, and 1 production slice, shown in red in the bottom middle. Note that this is the same physical network on which we read our email and surf the web. So, if the FlowVisor does not correctly maintain isolation between the slices, then we are the first to know about it. Given FlowVisor's strong isolation capabilities, we now have a novel technique to roll out new services. Specifically, users can selectively delegate control of a subset of their traffic to a new service. That is, they can opt in to the new service. For example, user Doug may decide that he wants his voice over IP traffic handled by KK's wireless slice for low latency, his web traffic handled by Nikhil's load balancing slice optimized for high throughput, and the rest of his traffic handled by a default production slice. Not just a good idea on paper, we actually deploy FlowVisor on real equipment on our own production network. In addition to Stanford, FlowVisor is deployed on 7 college campuses and in 2 backbone networks. If you would like to learn more about FlowVisor, please check out our OSDI 2010 paper, Can the Production Network Be the Testbed?, the FlowVisor's website, or just download the code from our code repository. Thank you.